Sony just dropped the 12-24 G Master f/2.8 lens. My biggest question is, how does it compare to the 14-24 2.8 Sigma, which is less than half the price? Let's compare them. All right, I'm gonna get straight to the point in this video. This video does not need to be long. Right now I'm filming on the 12-24 Sony f/2.8. The lens is right here in front of me, but you get to see everything. It's insanely wide. The biggest difference between the Sony and the Sigma is the 2mm. Does 2mm even matter? Let's find out. Hey babe, does 2mm matter on the wide end?
Yeah. And if anyone tells you different, then they're lying.
Told ya. All right, so this is what it looks like. This is a 12mm. Number 14. That's 14. Back to 12. Back to 14. Back to 12. There is a big difference. The 2mm goes a long way here, okay? And I noticed it when comparing these images, that there is, you can't just take a couple steps back with the 14 and get the look of a 12mm. This Sony lens is one of a kind. It's a unicorn lens that's out in the market right now. There have been 11-24 f4s, there have been 12-24 f4s, and there have been 14-24 f2.8s and f4s. There is no other lens like this. But guess what? You are paying unicorn money. You're spending $3,000. The Sony weighs in at 847 grams. The Sigma weighs 795 grams. So you see the Sigma is smaller and lighter. They're both weather sealed. The Sony has 17 elements in 14 groups. The Sigma has 18 elements in 13 groups. The minimum focusing distance of both lenses is 11 inches. The Sony has 9 aperture blades. The Sigma has 11 aperture blades. And both of these lenses have rear ND holders, putting the ND filter holders here. Hopefully third-party manufacturers will start making these. You could just slide them in there. I think that's pretty neat. I also compared the autofocus of these lenses. No difference at all. I locked myself in my super dark closet like a creep, shooting at 25,000 ISO, trying to find something different. And to me, and I found both lenses to be very, very good with autofocusing. Found no differences in speed, in accuracy. Thumbs up for both. Now, what do you really need to know about these two lenses? I pixel peeped my butt off to try to find something different about how they render, because that's the whole point, right? You wanna find something, but I couldn't find anything. The lenses are so good. They perform extremely well. I couldn't find any difference. The Sigma maybe has a little bit more contrast coming out of the camera. In my opinion, you're not choosing one over the other for image quality. You're choosing one over the other because you want that extra range. You want that 12mm at the wide f/2.8 aperture. If you don't need the 12mm, if you don't even know what you're missing, you get the Sigma and you're happy because you spent $1,400. But if you start comparing it, you may want the 12mm. Yes, the lens is a little bit bigger, it's a little bit heavier, it's a lot more expensive. But I did notice the difference. And if I was a wide angle guy, which I'm not, it's something that I would probably consider. Okay, so now for the thing that I'm most excited about. Tomorrow, I'm dropping a super wide angle portrait video that I did with Pierre Lampert, another YouTuber. We did some dope stuff in downtown Chicago, shooting at 12mm. It was so epic. Stay tuned for that video. Subscribe, because I'm gonna go edit. I'm gonna start editing it right now after this video. It's gonna be so dope. I'm so excited for it, all right? Stay tuned for the next one, guys. All right, I'll see you in the next video. See you tomorrow. Better be there. I don't know what I'm doing.